Hi everyone, this is Diane from Everything Ally. If you saw my last video on how to categorize your tasks to boost your productivity, you heard me talking about scheduling protected time to manage your critical tasks. Now, someone asked me if every entrepreneur I've worked with over the last 12 years had protected time. And the answer is yes, they all had some form of protected time on their schedule. So today, I'm going to delve a little bit deeper into what protected time is and why it's so vital for your business. What exactly is protected time? In my previous video, I mentioned that protected time is time that cannot be booked over, that cannot be repurposed. It is time that is specifically set aside for you to create, innovate, and add value to the most critical parts of your business. It's uninterrupted time for you to focus and sift through your thoughts so you can come up with really great ideas and solutions. If you're still not sure what I mean, think about all the times that you've had an light bulb moment and then you lost it because it wasn't able to fully develop before you were interrupted by the next phone call, email, or text message. Or think about all the times where you're mulling over a client issue or an opportunity, but you can't quite seem to get to the conclusion because you're distracted by everything around you. Protecting time allows these thoughts to come to you and for you to be able to think them through. And this is where the real magic happens because more often than not, the opportunities and solutions are right in front of us. We just have to clear the noise and the distractions to be able to see them. So why does protected time matter to entrepreneurs? Well, we live in a world of distractions, and as an entrepreneur, you are more susceptible to distractions than most simply because you have a lot more going on. Distractions are also more damaging to you than most because you ultimately set the vision and strategy for your business. Without you to set the direction, your business is rudderless and spinning its wheels and not moving forward. So it's really vital for you to have time set aside for you to refine and focus your vision and strategy. Not only that, but when you're working on the tasks that are critical to your business, it's interesting and engaging work, and that can be very motivating and energizing as you move forward. Last but not least, there's also a great deal of research out there that shows that to refocus after a distraction, it takes about 20 to 25 minutes. Do you really have this time to spare as you're trying to sustain and grow your business? Probably not. So give yourself the opportunity to focus and really develop your business. Now that you know what protected time is and why it's so important, how do you do it? Well, first things first, get it on your calendar. It doesn't have to be a lot of time at first. You can put down an hour a week. You can do it on a Monday. You could do it on Friday. You could do it on Wednesday afternoon. The most important things that you keep in mind is that it is consistently scheduled and that you're doing it at a time that is convenient and when you're relatively clear-headed. So I don't recommend doing it at 5 p.m. on a Friday before you have to sit in rush hour traffic. I also don't recommend doing it at intervals shorter than 60 minutes. It will take you a little bit of time to settle into that entrepreneurial mindset, and if you've ever had to force an idea, you know you can't rush it. Once you have it scheduled, you should plan for it. As I mentioned earlier, it can take a little bit of time for you to get your thoughts settled. So to help move this process along, you can plan what you want to think about during your protected time. Is there any overarching theme or opportunities that you've been presented that you haven't had the chance to fully consider? Write that down into your calendar block so you know exactly where you want your thoughts to go as soon as you sit down. Another way to do this is to ask yourself a series of prompts as you start your protected time. Some of these prompts could be, are there any major issues in my business or areas that need refinement? What would make me happier in my business? Where do I see myself and my business in the next month or 3 months or 6 months? The prompts can be totally your own. You can make up anything that you want. They're really just to get you thinking critically about where you are so you can improve today and set yourself up for success in the future. So my third and final tip for doing protected time is to just do it. It'll be really hard at first to stick to the schedule because you're so busy, and it'll be really easy to use this time to catch up on emails or everything else, but don't do it. Get into the habit of putting away your emails and focusing on what you have planned, because like everything else, it takes consistency to really see results, but once you do it, you'll see just how far you can take your business. Now that you have more background on why protecting time is so important for entrepreneurs and how to do it, don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Then leave a comment and let us know how you're doing or if there are any other topics that you want us to cover. Until next time, this is Diane from Everything Ally. We got your back.